Thank you. Thank you so much to the OMDC for this incredible honor. It's amazing to share this stage with such amazing writers, and it's amazing to be here tonight. Thank you so much. I'm going to read a little bit from one of the stories in my collection. It's called Start Being More Independent and Stop Telling Me You Love Me. As part of the research process for this book, I actually collected some of the things that people have said to them over the course of their relationships. Thank God this is not a personal experience, but it is something I heard, and I thought, wouldn't it be amazing if I could repurpose that statement? He came home that night to find Melanie packing her suitcase. She was crying in a way that looked violent, mascara streaking her olive skin like tie-dye, her gray eyes bloodshot, her full lips covered with tears or snot, he couldn't tell. Her curly black hair sprung and flew in every direction. He knew it was cruel, but his first thought was how far from beautiful she looked. Mel reminded him of a line in an Edward Albee play he'd been in when he was younger, something about having a fine sense of the ridiculous, but no sense of humor. He was 2 hours late. Elliot, she snapped, barely able to suppress her irritation. I can't believe you didn't have the decency to call or even text me once tonight. He sighed. He didn't answer. He went up to her and put his arm around her, and she pushed him away. He was amazed at the full force of her movement. He touched his arm gingerly. She'd actually hurt him. He stood watching her as she finished packing. He thought about going onto his balcony to have a cigarette. He thought about pouring himself a glass of Merlot that he kept in the fridge door. He thought about going into the living room and petting his beloved 13-year-old cat, Molly, who was probably lying on the couch waiting for him. But he didn't. He just stood there, frozen. A part of him wanted to mock applaud her. There was no way she was actually going to leave him. Melanie was too invested in appearance. Her parents were coming to town in 2 days. They were coming in part to meet him, in part for her university graduation. If he were to place a bet, it would be on her wanting to act like the happiest couple ever when they got there. She was always doing things like that. They'd have the biggest fight, and then he'd hear her telling one of her friends on the phone how great he was. Or he'd find her on Facebook, posting a happy couple profile photo from a week or two before. For some reason, her still wanting to be with him always made him apologize. She was acting like this to teach him a lesson. He had spoken to her parents a few times, her mom 2 or 3 times on the phone, her father once on Skype. They seemed like nice people, objectively speaking, but all he heard in their voices was expectation. Expectation that a 6-month relationship with their daughter would turn into an engagement. Expectations that he'd bring her back to Toronto, where they lived, even though he hated Toronto. Expectations that he'd get a better paying job, that they'd settle down together. She zipped up her suitcase and flopped down on top of it, exhausted. Come here, she said to him gently. He took her hands and helped her stand up. She rubbed her face against his broad shoulders the way she had hundreds of times. She unbuttoned the first 3 buttons of his striped blue shirt and rubbed her nose against his bare chest the way she often did. He reached down to kiss her, and she moved her face away. Elle, she said quietly, looking up at him, I really can't do this anymore. Thank you.